So we're wrapping up extensor tendons, right, this month. And I want you to understand, extensor tendons are challenging. They take a long time, they scar down. We all somehow know that, but we wanna be in denial about it. And they're challenging, but not impossible. But part of it is like how we wanna think through the case, like how we wanna think through what we need to get. And our own expectations. Our patients want it fast, right? To get it más rápido. Get it, right?
Como tú quieras. Lo mejor,
he's like,
lo mejor
whatever
para
you.
Ti. Lo mejor para ti. The best for you.
Yeah. That's right. Well, we all want, like we want somehow, like that we want it fast. It doesn't happen fast. And we have to manage our expectations so we can manage our patients' expectations. All right. This is an extensor tendon laceration and a fracture. So a twofold problem is that you have joint stiffness, right? So go back to my framework. I'm gonna talk about joint problems, tendon problems, ligament problems, nerve problems, skin and fascia, right? So he doesn't have a nerve issue. It's more of a skin and fascia type of problem, right? He has a joint problem in the sense that there's a lot of joint stiffness, right? He has, oh my God, this DIP, right? Joint stiffness. But it's so stiff too because the skin and fascia, the ligaments on the side that hold everything and the tendons that won't give. These are the extensors that will not give, right? He's had two surgeries already. The first one to pin, or the first one to pin and repair the laceration. The second one was to remove the pin, right? I don't really consider that a surgery, but since you consider a surgery, I'm gonna consider it a surgery. And then his third one was to release the tendons. This is where we at right now. It's very, very tight. So we're about 3 weeks out and it's getting tight again. Just understand that when you have a capsulotomy or a tenolysis, that it will, you know, start to stiffen and start to harden again as we heal. So I want you to think about where the bones are. Right on here, right? It's not permanent. So here, oh my God, who left the dry erase marker out? Put a cap on it. All right, here is P1, right? Relax, P, this is P1. This is P2, this is P3, right? Here's a bone, right? We've got ligaments on the side. We've got tendons on the side. We have these tendons right here, and then they go and they go right there. And then they're so tight, right? They're so tight. So he has a lot of lateral scarring, right? So if I go and I bend my joints, right? I'm bending, look at, he needs more extension. If you pull from here without holding here, you're kind of going into that like boutonniere thing. So you gotta make sure that you pull. So I always hook my hand because I need to control my wrist, and index fingers are funny because the thumb always likes to help. So I like to put my finger in between, and here I have full control. I have full control, right? To get really good IP extension. Sometimes you have to put that MP into flexion and like really just go ahead and pull it, right? And when you pull it, you can just do some gentle like or aggressive stretching, but you can also stretch and work the tissue at the same time, right? You feel that? So I'm pulling, do you see anything? Alivia, all right? So sometimes it's alleviating to pull the skin and fascia distally. Don't worry about the swelling and all that. It's worth it to pull it distally so that we can shorten this amount of scarring and tension on this side. On the distal end, right? He's got lateral tightnesses, right? So if I hold here, I also do this, one finger underneath P1, one under P2, and then I'm going to push down so I can get more extension, but this is, I wanna massage essentially on the side and to move the tissues on the side, alivia así or alivia para arriba. So usually there's a direction of pull that is more alleviating in terms of the tightness. So for him, it's actually pulling down versus pulling up. And you'll start to notice which ones like which direction based on if it's a flexor tendon or an extensor tendon. In this case, is an extensor. So he actually feels better. He has a lot, you can feel it. Like, we have a lot of connective tissue on the side, right? And so moving in that direction is going to help, and it's going to help stretch it. It's going to help move the tissues, right? And you can combine it with range of motion with soft tissue mobilization, right? And you get that, you get PIP, full extension, as much extension as possible, and then doble. So then it's the only way to get some DIP flexion, right? So it's not worth it working DIP flexion if this part is not giving, right? So hold this tight, work on some DIP flexion. Do you see that? Like, it's so tight right here. It's not, like, you can feel it doesn't give. Right here, look, it gives, right? This is not giving, so unforgiving. So you gotta work, like, essentially PIP area to get more DIP, right? Otherwise, you're gonna work composite PIP and DIP and really not go anywhere. Look how tight that is, right? So sometimes I'll work this to get this down. God, how are you so stiff? Que duro. His finger, and you know what? The index finger is very easy to stay stuck in extension because you can do everything without your index finger. So even if you don't think you're like, I'm using it, I bet you anything, you're going through your day using your finger like this. You can't help it. This is the natural attitude of the index finger. And then when you're trying to use it, your thumb gets in the way. And so the thumb blocks the DIP from, like, doing more. It wants to do more, but it can't do more because the thumb is very greedy. All right, so we sort of need to explain that to people so that they don't feel like they're doing something wrong, right? This is just a natural attitude, but believe it or not, when you get more extension, you'll get more flexion. You get more extension, you get more flexion. Right? And you can work, like, a lot of times they'll be real tight right here. What's here? Molar plate, where the flexor tendon and the extensor tendon, the flexor tendon of the profundus and superficialis meet. It will get stuck there, right? You can't get that extension, you're just not getting that flexion, right? Get extension first, and then get flexion after. With ease. Mejor? Right? And you'd be surprised. You can be so aggressive. So aggressive. How do I save my thumbs? Tip number 100. I double up my thumbs. I use both hands. Double up. Right? Get the whole tension. I'm not even working that hard. My arms are down. I'm relaxed. And they feel a lot of that pressure. Right. And they feel a lot of that pressure. I can move. Control your wrists, you'll move your fingers better. Get PIP, extension, and everything else will flow. Hey, Mina, this is better. Look at that. Feel that?
Hey.
Gracias. Okay, now. Whether you're starting out in hand therapy or sitting to study to become a certified hand therapist, I hope these videos help you. Click the like and subscribe button for more.